picture, I'm going to paint a rooster. They're really lovely to paint because they're such bright colours. Each type of rooster is individual. And I'm going to start by mixing a few colours all ready to go so they blend into each other. Some raw sienna, some burnt umber, and some alizarin crimson, which is exaggerating the colours, but it makes for a better watercolour and more vibrant. First, I'll get some raw sienna in. I'm looking for the very light bits at the moment to really bring those out. Some burnt sienna. And now some orange, cadamon orange, very, very thick, very little water. Into that I'm putting alizarin crimson, and that's very thick too with very little water. And then some burnt sienna, again very, very thick, hardly any water, and that will give you your vibrancy. You notice on the drawing that I've altered the feet slightly. That's because he's standing on one leg on my reference material, and that would look really strange. And so I've just made it look a little bit more interesting, a little bit more movement. Just pull that colour out around there. Just use a slightly smaller brush, the wash brush. And take some Prussian blue with just a little bit of colour on at the moment. And where you can see the light hitting it, keep that very light. And now I'm going in with some very, very thick Prussian blue. Nearly all pigment and hardly any water, and I'm going to try and get some dry brush marks on the paper. It's a rough paper, a rough arch. I'm just following the movements of the feathers through that I can see. Now the feet, I can use some cobalt blue mixed with a little bit of light red. And the comb can be alizarin crimson. You don't have to fill all this in, just marks here and there. Now I need to let that dry before I can do any more, and then I can put some more dry brush marks in. Right, now that's dry, I can put a few dry brush marks in. I'm going to use the all-rounder brush, which is slightly smaller. I'm going to use some sepia. I'm just going to look where a few of the feathers are and indicate just a little bit of the feather, but not too much, on the movement. You can overdo this bit and it would look sort of messy rather than a nice pure watercolour. I'm also going to put the beak in sepia, although it's quite light, but I do want it to stand out, and the eye. Just be careful not to make the eye too big. A little bit of shadow on there so that the foot shows up a little bit. A few more brush marks. We're going into the Prussian blue now. And just a few extra marks on the feathers at the back. And you can exaggerate them and it just makes it look a little bit more interesting, a little bit more fluffy. And I've got to let that dry and I'm just going to add some pastel for a little bit more colour. Right, now that the paint's dry, I can add the pastel, but you do have to make sure the paint is completely dry before you go in with pastel. I'm just matching the colours, the raw sienna for raw sienna, orange for orange. It doesn't have to be too accurate, but just a rough match. And just rub a little bit in and that will brighten it up where the watercolour's gone quite light. Now some orange. And then some blue for the tail feathers, and I can again exaggerate them quite a lot more. And we'll just put a shadow in underneath to finish it off. At the moment he looks like he's floating. So with the wash brush, we can pick out some of the colours that we've got in the hand, so the orange will be quite nice, and taking that into the Prussian blue. I've just made it slightly diagonal to make it more interesting rather than a straight shadow. And that's the rooster completed. Our next painting is going to be some pigs. I've driven past these on lots of occasions and they were just lying down and not doing anything. On this occasion they were hungry and they were waiting to be fed, and it was just an ideal opportunity. There were rows and rows of them, and I've just taken out three to show you how to break it down and simplify it. Now we'll start with the foreground wash, which is some raw sienna. I'm just going to wash that on. Quite pale to start with, and we're only going to use three colours, a raw sienna, an alizarine crimson and a French ultramarine. And whilst that's still wet in the very foreground, I'll just add some neat raw sienna, and that will just break up the wash a little bit. Now I need to just let that dry before I start on the pigs. Right, now the foreground's dry, I'm going to start painting the pigs. I'm just going to use the wash brush, and with a mix of raw sienna and a little bit of alizarine crimson added, we'll start with the middle pig. Where the light's hitting him on his back, it's very, very pale, so well washed out. Lots of water, very little pigment. And that gets slightly thicker, so slightly more pigment, slightly less water as we come down for the medium tone. Make that slightly more raw sienna on the top of his head. But the light's hitting it, so it does need to be quite pale. And then just slightly pinker this side. That's a very pink nose. That leg's quite in the sunlight, so you can keep that quite light, and quite a lot darker the other side.